Well, here we are with another update to Lightroom, and this time we are at version 8.5. This one can be classified as an overall performance boost and bug fix update, but that doesn't mean that there aren't some notable improvements, especially to the Generative Remove and Distracting People removal tools. Now, on top of that, Adobe Camera Raw added a brand new feature that's in early access, and I thought it'd be cool to show it to you here, even though the video is about this Lightroom update. After all, Lightroom and ACR work pretty much hand in hand, so that's probably precedent enough. And rounding things off, we've also made more improvements to the AI Edit status menu, making the entire experience using it clearer and more intuitive. All right, let's dive in. All right, so this is Lightroom 8.4. This is the version that everyone has unless you've already grabbed the newest version, which is 8.5. And it'll allow me to illustrate the issue that some users would have when using Gen Remove, because it really depends on the type of stroke that you make. So watch, I'm gonna go ahead here and just make this really loose stroke of this person that I want to get rid of. I'm gonna go ahead and click on Remove. You can see that in some cases, there's a hallucination that's made where an object is introduced. So in this case here, you can see in each of these variations, there's just something random that you probably didn't want. It really depends on the stroke that you make. And especially if you've included the shadow, if there is one, or a reflection. If you don't, then that's where we've seen sometimes hallucinations could occur. Fortunately, it's gotten a lot better with Lightroom 8.5 because we have a way more improved Firefly model. All right, so this is Lightroom 8.5, and all I did was reset the edits here. I'm gonna do the exact same thing as I did before, where I'm just gonna make this kind of rough stroke around the person and click on Remove. And there you go. I mean, you can see it is a significantly better removal. There are no objects that were introduced. It's just way, way better. Now, there's also another bonus improvement to this improved Firefly model. In addition to being much better and not kind of hallucinating objects, it's also faster, like up to 2 times faster, especially when you make subsequent strokes. So watch, I'm just gonna go ahead here and remove this person. Then I'll go ahead and try removing this sign. And I'm just gonna remove this. And so as you remove these spots, you should notice that the performance is faster. Okay, so we are back in Lightroom 8.4, and I wanna just do one more example just to illustrate to you the improvement. So again, I'm gonna go ahead here and make a stroke over these two little girls on an ice skating rink, and I'm gonna click on Remove. And you can see here, again, we introduce something that we more than likely did not want. And also again, this has gotten a lot better in Lightroom 8.5. And one quick thing before we move to 8.5 to show you how that performs. The improvement isn't just to the Gen Remove brush. It also will improve your Distracting People removal tool, because both of those tools use the same Firefly model. So both of them should get a lot better. And once again, we're in Lightroom 8.5. And just like before, I'm gonna make pretty much the same stroke as I did in Lightroom 8.4. Click on Remove. And you can see way better. Now, of course, I can go ahead and remove other things. And you should notice, I mean, I've used Gen Remove enough to where when I remove and I see just how much faster it is, it's awesome. You know, as I keep making these strokes here and get rid of different subjects throughout the frame, it just is a lot snappier. All right, so for the second improvement here, this has to do with Adobe Camera Raw, like I mentioned, and it addresses, I know for me, one of the things that I've been asking for years, quite literally, and I know a lot of other users have been asking for it, and so it's made its way into Adobe Camera Raw first as an early access feature, and it's auto dust spot removal. Let me show you how it works. So you can see I've got this image here. It was taken a long time ago, 2009. And back in the day, I don't know, my images for some reason had so many more dust spots in them than they do now. And I've always cleaned my sensor, but I don't know. I don't know what it is. But if you were to look at the images from like 10, 15 years ago to the last 5 years, there's no contest. Like I was a lot better now, I guess, with preventing dust. I don't know. But now it doesn't even matter because in one click you can get rid of pretty much all of it. And to do that, what you'll do is I have this DNG here, like I just mentioned. I'm going to drag it onto Photoshop because it'll automatically load Adobe Camera Raw. Now you'll want to make sure that you have Adobe Camera Raw 17.5 installed before you do this. Another thing you'll want to make sure of is you go to the gear icon here, click on technology previews, and then make sure that new AI features is enabled. And so now, again, if I zoom in, let me just kind of show you just how ridiculous it is. Like all of this dust and just crud everywhere. I mean, it's so bad. And normally, you know, I would go ahead and remove each of these one at a time, and it was really frustrating. Now, all I need to do is go to the remove panel, and you will see under distraction removal, there were just two before, but now there are three. There was reflections and people, which I covered in the previous What's New video for Lightroom. But in Adobe Camera Raw, we will have dust. All you need to do is expand it. Before I click on apply, I want to focus on this early access button just really quickly. Anytime you see early access in Adobe Camera Raw or in Lightroom or in one of the other apps, it just means that the tool is still being worked on. It should not be considered as final. Things can change. The name of the tool can change. It might not even make it in whatever final version that we ship. So for now, use it and let us know what you think, because there is a provide feedback option that I'll show you in a second too. So you can see it says once enabled, Camera Raw will identify and remove dust spots from this photo. So I'm going to go ahead and click on apply. And when I hover over, you can see all of the different dust overlays that it detected and removed. Now I mentioned how, you know, you can provide feedback, which I highly recommend. If it's just not good or if it is good, let us know. Now, when you select on any of these dust spots, you have two options. You can either use refresh or delete, and refresh will just attempt to refresh it, and delete will get rid of it if for some reason it inadvertently removed like a false positive, it removed something that it shouldn't have, you can just get rid of it. And so to visualize how good this is, I'm gonna go to the remove brush. I'm gonna activate this gen remove brush, and then I'm gonna turn on visualize spots. And so you can see this is the sky with the dust removed. And if I toggle the mute over here for dust, do you see how much was done in one click? I didn't have to do any of that. ACR handled it in just one click. And to me, this is awesome. Now, it did miss some. You can still see if I kind of zoom in a bit and then pan around, you can see it missed a few. And so I could use either the gen remove brush or the content aware brush and, you know, get rid of those manually. But it's a heck of a lot better than having to, you know, get rid of these lingering ones and all of these other ones. So I'm going to go ahead now and click on done to commit that to the DNG. And then I'm going to move to Lightroom in local. And the reason why I want to do that is because I also mentioned that there has been an improvement to the AI edit status window. If you remember, the AI edit status window gives you more insight into the order of operations for AI tools that you apply. If you apply AI tools outside of that order of operations, it's totally fine, but you could invalidate certain pixels. And so when you do, you have to update everything. So now it's gotten even, I would say, more clearer and more intuitive. All right, so here, this is the image. You can see that Lightroom, even though we currently don't have dust removal in Lightroom, it was able to render the dust removal pixels from Adobe Camera Raw. And you can see this is the AI edit status button that I was referencing. When you click on it, this is the menu. And you can see that we do recognize distraction removal dust from Adobe Camera Raw, but because it sits above or upstream the adaptive profile that I initially applied, you can see that it needs to be updated. It's indicated by this yellow border, and all you need to do is click on this update all button. And when we click back, you can see we're in a good state. But there is a really important thing to understand. Notice how in this example, the AI tool that needed updating was downstream of Dust. Well, what happens if I apply an AI tool that sits upstream of Dust? Well, pretty much the one tool that I know for a fact sits pretty much at the top of the list is AI denoise. So I'm going to go ahead and enable it, because this allows me to illustrate another major improvement to the AI edit status menu. And when you click on it over here, this is the improvement. Because Dust is not currently in Lightroom, and I applied an AI tool that is at the top or upstream of the others, it invalidated the two tools under it. Now, adaptive profile is not a problem because that is in Lightroom. However, because Dust is not currently in Lightroom, if I update, you can see here, unable to update will be removed. And so again, what that means is that if I click on update all, which I will in a second, because the Dust removal tool is not currently in Lightroom, it will restore the original pixels. Effectively, it will get rid of the spot removals that you did in Adobe Camera Raw. That doesn't mean that you can't remove them again in Lightroom. You would just have to use the Gen Remove brush or the Content Aware brush and remove them manually. So you can see here, again, because I added denoise, which is at the top of the order of operations, and Dust and Adaptive Profile sit downstream of it, they've been invalidated, and I would click Update All. Now, before I do one more time, you might be asking, well, how can I prevent this? The way that you could prevent it is by using the order of operations. I'll link to it below, but basically, in addition to HDR, which primarily affects certain types of like iPhone and Google Pixel images that have JPEGs with gain maps, the most important thing that you can do is apply denoise right at the beginning. Again, that's pretty much at the top. Technically on the list, it's number two, but for all intents and purposes, you should consider it as the number one thing. If I applied denoise first, and then I brought that DNG into Adobe Camera Raw, and then applied the distraction removal tool for Dust, we wouldn't have any problems. So I'm gonna go ahead here and click on update. And again, it updates. And as you can see here, my beautiful Dust spots are back. And if I go to AI edit status, another thing you'll notice is that the distraction removal Dust line item is gone because again, it is not in Lightroom. So watch this. I'm gonna go ahead now, I'm gonna click on grid. Basically what that does is it writes the edits to the XMP within the DNG. I'm gonna go back here. Let me hide Photoshop for a second. And now let me open that DNG again. And you can see if I click on the same AI edit status button, there it is, denoise and adaptive profile. These have been already applied in Lightroom. And so what I'm free to do once again is go to Dust, click on apply. You can see that the dust spots have been removed, but we also need to update the adaptive profile. I'm going to click on update all here. I'm going to click on done, and then I'll just swipe over to Lightroom. You can see here we are again. We've got our dust removed, and if I click on the AI edit status button, you see we have all three of the tools in a good state. None of them have been invalidated. Now, I completely get it if this is overwhelming to you. It took me a while to really kind of wrap my head around what this whole AI order of operations is and the AI edit status button and the window. I'm going to create a whole separate video just on this to walk you through how that works. So don't worry, that's going to be coming very soon. But for the most part, you at least now know what you need to kind of keep in mind if you want to take advantage of, say, denoise and the new dust removal tool in ACR. You know that if you're going to do both, or if you're going to apply both, make sure you just apply denoise first. In general, partly because denoise already sits so high on the order of operations, and also in general, it's the thing that I apply at the beginning of my editing workflow. It's just a good idea that if you know you're going to edit a certain raw file, just apply denoise right away. By doing that in Lightroom, you kind of save yourself a lot of the potential headaches like this because Dust sits downstream of denoise. If denoise is already there when you open it up in Adobe Camera Raw, you're good to go. You can have fun with having your denoise, having your dust removal, and not really worrying about that causing it to be invalidated in Lightroom, and then you lose all of the dust removal spots. So I hope all of this really gets you excited with the improvements. Again, the improvements to Gen Remove should not be understated. It's awesome. The fact that it does a much better job of not introducing hallucinations. And like I said, it's up to 2 times faster. It is way faster. Go back and watch the removal from Lightroom 8.4 of the two images. Look how long it took, and then go and watch the 8.5 version, and you will see it is quite fast. Of course, this is just kind of a small component, a small improvement to Lightroom for desktop. If you want to learn everything there is to know about Lightroom for desktop, for mobile, and for web, please check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Now, there's also a bunch of other stuff that I cover for Lightroom. It's all in this playlist here, so you can just check it out. And of course, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is greatly appreciated, as is clicking on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.